appeared to be like it was from November, December, and January. And I hope that people pay attention to this. This is a real issue. And what I'm raising here is vital to national security. We cannot allow Americans' names to be either masked improperly or unmasked improperly. And we have a duty and a responsibility to get to the bottom to see if this was done properly or not.
Was there anything illegal?
It depends. We don't know yet. We do know that there was one name, the only crime that we know has been committed so far, assuming that General Flynn was picked up on some type of incidental collection. That was illegally leaked, if that is in fact the case, and that is
any other names illegally leaked, unmasked?
We don't know yet, but there are additional names that were unmasked.
Because previously you suggested there were.
Yeah, no, no. There are additional names that were unmasked, and that's what raised concern to me.
But you saw actual names in the reports you read at the White House complex?
Yeah, I mean, it was pretty clear who they were talking about, what the reports were referring to.
But you were concluding who the names were. Did you actually see names?
For the most part, they were masked. But like I said, there was additional unmasking, which is why we're trying to get the intelligence agencies to cooperate and provide us the information so we can figure out who asked for that name to be unmasked and who the name was.
Because you say for the most part, elaborate. I want if you could be specific. Were there specific names that were inappropriately, if not illegally, unmasked?
So I don't know if. I think inappropriately is for sure the case. But what we should do here is we should wait until we get all the evidence to our committee. That's going to take a while. It's going to take a while for us to comb through it. But what I will say, and I'll be as clear as I can on this, it bothered me. As somebody who supports our national security apparatus, it bothered me that this level of information would be included in intelligence reports because it just wasn't necessary. From my point of view, legal or not.
Were the calls in question, the transition team calls, that individuals were unmasked, were they involving foreign governments intercepted by U.S. intelligence or discussions by foreign governments about calls they may have had with Trump officials?
I can't get into that because, as you know, a lot of what we do is classified in nature. But I will say that it had absolutely nothing to do with Russia. All the reports I saw had nothing to do with Russia, which is why I thought it was completely appropriate for me to the next day to go and talk to the president about this and why I thought this needed his attention. And look, we had been asking we already suspected this. I mean, I had people who had already told me this existed. And we've been asking the agencies since March 15th to provide us the names that were unmasked.
But you, and let me, I know you have to go vote, and I'd love you to come back after you vote because there's a bunch of other questions I'd love to ask you.
This is a lot of questions.
I know it's a lot of questions, but yeah. This is important, and you have the answers. But very quickly before you vote, and hopefully you'll come right back after the vote, do you understand why it might have been better to avoid that kind of meeting at the White House?
Yeah, but look, when I went over there, I was expecting to see what had been described to me. I was not expecting to see what I saw. And that's why there was nothing clandestine about it. It was simply just going through there, saying hi to people, going in, looking at what I needed to look at, figuring out it had nothing to do with Russia at all, and had everything to do about American citizens being caught up in surveillance of some kind. And I thought that it was important for the president to know, and that's why the following day I went and briefed him.
One final question. I know you're going to go and vote. Those four tweets from 3 weeks ago that the president leveled those charges against President Obama for ordering the wiretapping of Trump Tower, you don't believe that, do you?
No. I mean, I said just days after that that it didn't happen. Days after that, and largely the media.
So he should not feel vindicated.
Well, look, I'm not going to get into how people feel or don't feel. I just know that I was very clear with all of the media and the American public that I didn't think that those tweets were accurate. However, I will say, I said this the whole time, I am concerned about additional unmasking and if any other surveillance activities were used. And look, it clearly that appears to be the case in this matter.
Mr. Chairman, you've been very generous with your time. I know you got to run and vote. If you can come back, we'll continue this conversation. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you, Wolf. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Just ahead, we're going to talk about what we just heard from the chairman. Our political team is standing by.
Hello, I'm an Idaho potato farmer, and I finally found our big Idaho potato truck.
What's up, guys? It's Sawhill here. You guys are watching The Progressive Voice. Make sure you guys click subscribe down below. We're fighting Donald Trump tooth and nail, and we need your help.